Have you ever wondered how long it took for the promise of Genesis chapter 3 verse 15 to be fulfilled? From Adam and Eve came Seth, but no savior. Enos, Cainan, then Mahalalel, but no Messiah. Jared, then Enoch, who walked with God, but he was not the promised seed. Methuselah, Lamech, then Noah, who endured a flood, but he was not the one who would be wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities, and by whose stripes we are healed. Shem, Arphaxad, then Salah, but no savior. Eber, Peleg, then Ru, but no Messiah. Serug, Nahor, then Terah, and the fulfillment of God's promise in Genesis 3:15 had not yet come to pass. But don't give up. Abraham, Isaac, then Jacob, the patriarchs, but still no deliverer. Judah, Perez, Hezron, Ram, Aminadab, Nashon, then Salmon, but nothing yet. Boaz, whose mother was Rahab, Obed, whose mother was Ruth, Jesse, then the great King David, and I'm just wondering, when is God going to fulfill his promise? But don't give up and don't give in. Solomon, Rehoboam, Abijah, Asa, Jehoshaphat, Jehoram, Uzziah, Jotham, Ahaz, Hezekiah, Manasseh, Amon, Josiah, Jehoiakim, Shealtiel, Zerubbabel, Abiud, Eliakim, Azor, Zadok, Akim, Eliud, Eleazar, Mathan, Jacob, then Joseph, the husband of Mary, the mother of Jesus, the Christ child born in Bethlehem, raised in Nazareth, baptized in the river Jordan. He is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Promise fulfilled. No matter how long, hold on to the promises of God. I'm Pastor B, and this has been More Than Just a Minute.